From the pen of William Rimmer, Glen Cathra, ladies and gentlemen, which I believe, Gary, can you correct me, a hill, a mountain,
a big hill,
where? Lake District, ladies and gentlemen. So if you ever, you're in the Lake District and you fancy walking up a big hill, maybe that little tune will pop into your mind and you think, oh, this is what he was thinking about. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know why this man stood up. The next piece is a full band piece. Just joking. Ladies and gentlemen, we have got something very special for you next. Something very special indeed. So the band was formed in 1881, and Gary was a founder member. That's not true, ladies and gentlemen. What we've got here, ladies and gentlemen, is a Frenchman. And we've flown him all the way in from France just to play this solo for you this evening. This is a wonderful piece of music. No idea it's composed by. Any? William Relton. Bill. Oh, Bill. Yes? We don't care who wrote it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a wonderful piece of music called Chevalier d'Honneur. And to play that for you, Mr. Gary Loyada. Something I said. He's not really French. Thank you.
Something, yeah, fantastic playing. Do you know how many notes are in that piece? A lot. Good. I don't know either. It was a lot, wasn't it? No, he played spectacularly well. In fact, one more round of applause, please, for Gary Lloyd. So it was... Somebody said I was the new MD. Could be another one next time. Ladies and gentlemen, it would be remiss of me not to mention in 2 days' time it's Halloween. Correct? Yes. Why did the skeleton not go trick-or-treating?
I don't know. Why did the skeleton not go trick-or-treating?
Because he got nobody to go with.
Oh.
It was better than that.
That's the spirit.
This one would be better. Madam, can you help me? Very, very simple. Very, very simple. 5 ghosts enter a room. 2 ghosts leave the room. How many ghosts are left? There's no ghosts. There's no such thing as ghosts. Now grow up. Dear, oh dear, ladies and gentlemen. I thought we were intelligent at Fours Earth Planet. You've proven me wrong again. Well done. Thank you for helping out. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to introduce the next piece. It doesn't need any instruction at all. Please have fun. Join in, please, if you would.
We'll be right back.
Special mention, ladies and gentlemen, to Simon Buddy Rich Barrow. You won't mind me telling you, ladies and gentlemen, missed rehearsal on Thursday. Oh, yeah, I know. That's why I played it a bit faster. Should never miss... This can't be right. Does this happen every week? It's just us, isn't it? It is just us. Ladies and gentlemen, the Invisible Man now is going to play for you. Ah! Talk amongst yourselves, Angel. You're having a lovely evening. I know you're missing not only Songs of Praise, All Creatures Great and Small, and the Strictly result. But it's worth it, isn't it? Just for this, surely. And who says entertainment has to be dressing in a wig? Just the... Oh, okay, so. Marvellous. Ladies and gentlemen, unbelievably, this isn't a comedy number. This is actually quite a serious piece of music. You've heard it before many times, but not as well as this, I'm sure. Ladies and gentlemen, to play for you, Share My Yoke, please will you put your hands together for the one and only Shuey. Oh, that's all right. They haven't even clapped yet. I said put your hands together for you, and they've not even done it. Shall I try it again? In fact, if I stand this way, they might hear me. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Shuey. story's great, isn't it? Doesn't matter when or where, whether you've heard it 100 times or not, every time you hear it, it's still one of those very emotional, evocative pieces, which is beautiful. And so expertly played by our wonderful flugel player, Stephen Barrow. Now, what I didn't realise, ladies and gentlemen, because it's my first time and I'm a virgin. He's laughing at that. Oh. You might know different, madam. I didn't realise. Will I get invited? Will I get invited back? Issue. I didn't realise, ladies and gentlemen, that the actual conductor of the band was adjudicated on their knowledge of their music that they're actually performing to them. Because, I'll be honest with you, I've been doing this for a little while, not with this band, and it's never been really my thing, if that makes sense. So I'm dreading to see the results of the adjudication. Stuart? Yes? Would you like a pint? or two, maybe? But I would thought I'd just read out this, just so you know exactly what this piece is about. So the next piece we're going to play for you, ladies and gentlemen, from the composer Philip Spark, I'm sure we all know in this room, is a piece called A Klezmer Carnival. Now, Klezmer music originated in the Shteti. It's after nine, it's okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're past the watershed. We won't get taken off air for that. They're villages, actually, or ghettos in Eastern Europe, where itinerant Jewish troubadours known as Klezmorim had performed celebrations, particularly weddings, since the early Middle Ages. Now, Klezmer is a Yiddish term combining the Hebrew words klei, which is an instrument, and zemer, which is song. No, I'll try that again. Zemer, which is song, not semer, which is song. But it's close enough. Now, the roots of the style are found in secular melodies, popular dances, Jewish hazanut, oh, I nearly said hazelnut, cantoral music, and also the wordless melodies intoned by the, not that one either, the Orthodox Jews. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this is a fun piece of music. This is indeed a Klezmer Carnival.
Thank you.
Hoy indeed, ladies and gentlemen, hoy indeed. So we've come to the final piece in our programme. It's sadder than that. It's sadder than that. It's not that. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the final piece. The reason for that is it's a little bit longer than the usual final piece. So I've chosen to play for you this evening a wonderful piece of music. Really, really fantastic music, well written. And what we don't really hear very often is the third movement from this suite. So we're going to delight you with it this evening. So the piece is Suite Gothique. And we're going to play the third movement and the fourth movement, the Toccata and the Priere Notre Dame. Now, Leon Baldwin, who composed this, and you can write this down. I'm sure on my facts on this. Sure on my facts. Famously, never wrote any notes about the piece. So most composers, not all of them, but most of them who compose a piece of music have a thought in mind or some sort of notes that accompany the music, which helps the conductor to try and portray the music out to the audience. Leon Baldwin decided, I'm not going to do that, I'm going to make life difficult for you, pal. So here is our interpretation, and let me tell you what's in my head, and hopefully this will transcend to you. So we all know Notre Dame, Paris, correct? We all know The Hunchback. So this is my version of it, okay? This is nobody else's, this is not official in any way, shape or form. Please don't take me to the cleaners or sue me, because I can't afford it. But in my head, the third movement, what I believe, is the beast is in the tower. And basically he's having a dream, and he's dreaming of meeting the woman of his dreams. He's seen her pass by through the cathedral many, many times. He's completely in love with her, but she doesn't notice him. And he dreams of taking her to a fancy ball in Paris and whisking around the ballroom in the beautiful Paris theatres that they have there, obviously with the gold walls and things like this. But ultimately, it's all a dream. And it takes us to the Toccata. And he wakes from the dream, and he's furious. And he gets crosser and crosser that he can't have what he wants. And he tears the cathedral apart. You can hear the rats scurrying around as they're trying to get away from him. As he moves through the cathedral, tearing pillars down in his absolute fury. To the grand conclusion, where the cathedral falls. That's my idea. Hope it transcends to you, ladies and gentlemen. Can I just say you've been an absolutely marvellous audience. We've really, really enjoyed playing for you. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming out on a wet, rainy Sunday night. I know there's better things to do, but we've enjoyed playing for you. Thanks ever so much for being here. Please have a safe journey home, and we hope to see you again soon.